For me, I know in my own teaching, one of the things that was really important to me was to stop looking at my class as a group and start looking at them as individuals and realizing that it was not even feasible that exactly the same experience was happening for all those kids when we did something in the classroom. Really to kind of look at them with the notion that they come to us with different language backgrounds, certainly with different genders, with different degrees of security, with different past experiences in school, with different levels of self-confidence about the subject, with different peer relationships, a thousand things that can intervene in there to affect what happens in a teaching and learning situation. And so for me, differentiation kind of begins when I actually just can make myself look eyeball to eyeball with what's really a pretty scary reality, and that is that room full of kids is different from each other. And those differences make a difference. And if I want to do the best job of teaching that I can spend a pretty good chunk of my career trying to understand those differences and respond to those differences. It's not something you do on a day. It's a commitment to say I can look harder, I can look beneath the surface, I can understand a few more things, I can peel back a little more of the surface than I've been able to do before. And to the degree that I can acknowledge and accept those differences and then start working with them as a part of my teaching plan, I'll probably do better. That for me is sort of a genesis of differentiation, I guess. And so then, for me, differentiation becomes responsive teaching rather than one-size-fits-all teaching. I've looked at the kids, I really understand that the differences they bring shape who they are. And in fact, it's actually, to me, why teaching's interesting. I'd hate to get the same set of widgets in every hour of every day for 35 years. What's so cool is that they are so different from each other and that they do bring that element of unpredictability with them. And if I can really look at those differences and can really wrap around the fact that those differences matter, then at some point, hopefully, what I'm going to do is say to myself, you know what? When I teach, I have to respond to those differences. I can't look past them. I have to look at them, and I have to plan with them in mind. That doesn't mean that we jettison the content that we're responsible for. Clearly, we have major responsibilities for content that has important implications for kids, even if you overlook the test part. What it means is we quit just teaching content and we become keenly aware that we have to teach content to human beings, and in order to transfer that content so that it becomes a part of their lives, we have to teach it to individuals rather than just teach it. And I think that's a hard thing. I think it's a hard thing. I think it's hard enough to just cover the content. That seems beyond us most days because it has to happen so fast and there's so much of it. But differentiation suggests that to get it right, if all we care about is making sure that kids learn, we have to teach individuals the content and we have to make sure that it's working for them.